So the few things we have understood in the last session is like how to select the nodes. The node selection will be happening by the special tool that is called shape tool, right? So hope we have understood how to select the nodes by F10 button. So where is that Corel? So hope this is maintained by yourself. F10 has been already introduced. I don't find the message here, but yes, F10, the button which is for shape tool, which helps to make the selection of the nodes. Now, after before selecting the nodes, we understood how many type of cursor are there and what does it mean. So here, every line does have a tail and a head. The tail is the start part and the head is the end part. Okay. So what is tail? What is head represents inside a line? Now, tail doesn't have add button, but head does have add button. This is what we have learned in the last session. The add allow you to add the nodes just in between the next and the selected node. If multi nodes are selected, then it will create a midpoint in between 2, 3, 4 and all. So this is what we have understood in the last session. Now the next point, how to select the point nodes and how to break the nodes. Breaking of the nodes, we have understood. Then after, we got to know a break line is not a group line, it is a combined line. A new word we have understood in the last session, it's called combine. So combined lines does have a single property. It changes all this thickness together, though they are separate. Now, how to recognize, does the line is a combination of multiple line or it is a single line? By the help of your shape tool. The time we switch to the shape tool, immediately it will reflect multiple head and tail mark on the line. It indicates that it is not a single line, it is multiple line. So now you have understood how to recognize a multiple strokes in a single line by the help of your shape tool and by seeing to the multiple head and arrow mark. Next, it is technically called as combine object. It is technically called as a combine object. Multiple object having single property and it changes at a single time, then it is not a group object, it is a combine object. Now, how to break a combine object? Going to the object menu and asking to the software, break curve apart, then what happened? There is no reaction initially, but the time we are clicking outside and clicking once more, then we find the reaction. We can see only certain part of the line is capable of selecting because the line are now break apart. So hope we have understood what is the relation between combine and the opposite is break apart. Both of them are there inside a single window, that is a menu that is called object menu. In the object menu, we find these two operations. Multiple objects together, but multiple objects can be separate out. This command is CTRL plus K, break apart. Now, if multiple object to be get combined into same, then we can go for the next operation called combine. select multiple object and go to the object menu, and you can find the option called combine. Now, why to combine? Once you are combining the things, then we can select these two separate nodes and you can join them. So hope we have understood why to combine. Let us see if it is not combined and the object is break apart, then what happens? At a time, we can select only one line's node point, not multiple lines. So now we have understood why to combine necessary for multiple objects, so that they will come into a single property. Once they come up into a single property, then after the operation of joining could be done. Select these two. Now we have understood here how to join two nodes by bringing them to a single point. But instead of bringing them to a single point, we can make them to stay at that same distance and get a straight line and join them. And it could be done. It could be done by this particular operation, extend curve to close, extension curve. Hope we have understood now these two buttons different. This is add break apart and this is add apart, join to, but it is closed state. So in both the case, we are joining only, but it is with extra line. But if you go for this one, then two points, two nodes turn into single nodes. So hope we have understood now how to make a line, how to break a line, how to make separate color in two lines, how to combine the lines, and what is the difference between the two command, control K, control L. This is two important hotkey of CorelDRAW. So it make the whole game. So let us see how we can able to take the advantage of it. Fine. So step number one, F5. Step number two, hold the shift and drag. Step number three, switch to F10. Step number four, control A, select all. Step number five, we can go on adding, select this, add. Now break it up. How to break? Select all. Break the nodes first. After breaking the nodes, we'll go for break apart by the object menu. Break up apart. Then individual part can be moved separately. Hope this much of things are clear. Now it is the time to go for getting them combined once more. Why to combine? To join them. So joining, combine can be done in two different manners. Either we can select all, then after we go for combine, control L, or is this, you can find the symbol over here. The similar kind of symbol will be there in the option bar. We can make all them to combine. So it again makes it up much more faster. So once the object become combined, then it is no more separate object. It is a single object. So at present, we can join them. Join them. So hope we have understood how to join the nodes. Right? So we have disturbed the position and get them combined. And after combining, we have made extension to close. Once more, these two are there. We can close the line by a single button. In F10, there is an option called closing. Close the curve. Extension is one thing and closing the things is another thing. Hope this much of things are clear. How to make a line, how to add the nodes, how to break a line, how to move the line, how to join them together by the help of your extension. This one. So one, 2, 3, 4, 5 option are clear. Now we'll move to few more options to get these nodes to be under your control. Select this with a straight line, and here you can find two options. Either you need to break it, or we need to get convert to curves. So let us see what happens if we convert into curves. So slowly you will get a tangent, it make it smooth surface. Convert to curves, this option. Fine, so let us do some exercise so that we can able to understand it proper. How to join two lines? Get a duplicate, bring over here, select all. What is to be done? Combine, or else you cannot able to join. What is the keyboard shortcut? Control L. What is the icon in your menu bar? This is the icon for combining. Why to combine? To close this. Select the nodes, extension close. Select the nodes, extension close. So hope we have understood now how to make a closed shape from a open shape. Right? Control L and Control K. Now once we have done a square, yes, we can make it separate once more by the help of your same process. Select the points, break it up. Select the points, break it up. And select the object and go for break apart. And select the object, right click. And yes. Change the thickness. Once we change the thickness, we can change the color. How to make a multicolor square border? Next, we can change the style. Hope this much of things are clear. Now I got to know how to make a simple line to turn into a square, and then like square or closed surface, and get them separate out. So let's move to more same line tools interaction. How to make a line from straight line to a curve line? Question over. Answer. Go to the shape. Select the node, this is first, this is last, and switch to the option called convert to curve. This is more important. Why to make convert to curve? So that will get tangent. Why to get tangent? Because we need to bend the line. So hope we have understood now how to use this particular tangent. Tangent is a straight line which comes from the node to make the path to turn into curve. So hope we have understood now what is the value of tangent and how does tangent come up in a straight line. Now once it is clear, then select the points, all this, and reverse direction. So let us see what is called reverse direction. We can understand it by putting a arrowhead. So if you need, suddenly it is to be get reverse again, going there next time. Select this now, reverse path. Right now, then close. So hope all these options are clear.
It's a small doubt, sir.
Chepandi.
సార్ మనం ఇవి మనం జాయిన్ చేసాం కదా సార్, అవి లైన్ నుంచి ఈచ్ వన్ కలర్ యాడ్ చేసాం కదా, సో అవి షార్పర్ అడ్జస్ట్ కావాలంటే సార్?
ఇదేనా?
Yes sir, exactly.
Okay, great sir. Nice question. ఇది ఎడ్జ్ షార్ప్ చేయాలా?
Yes sir.
ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ చేయాలి. చూడండి ఇక్కడ మేకప్ అయిపోతా.
అవును సార్, అవును సార్, అవును సార్.
You can, yes, it's a very nice question. So everybody observe it. It's a sensitive question. And we have learned two commands. What are those? The cur, properties, alternator, right?
Yes, cap, line cap.
Yes, you have done. You have given the answer. Is it clear now?
Yes. So here is the illustrator, sir.
Alternator. ఈ అకౌంట్ ఉంది నా డాకర్ మీదే ఆల్టెంటర్ ఉంటుంది క్లిక్ చేస్తే ప్రాపర్టీస్ వస్తాయి ఇది కూడా చేయొచ్చు లేదంటే ఏమి F12 నోట్ ఇట్ డౌన్ F12 బటన్ అక్కడ కూడా మనం ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ చేయొచ్చు నైస్ నైస్ క్వశ్చన్ సార్ ఎస్ అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్స్ ఇట్ కుడ్ బి ఎ క్వశ్చన్ ఎస్ డ్రాగ్ ఇట్ అప్ గివ్ ఎ ఎలక్ట్రిక్ డూప్లికేట్ అండ్ వైల్ యూ ఆర్ మేకింగ్ ఇట్ డౌన్ The thickness is not changing and it can be done in the F12 scale with object on. So if we are scaling the object down, the thickness also gets down. So hope we can see now these two thickness different. Is it clear? So this option yes, is also there in the F12 button, which is not visible in the front end. Two options to be taken care of, scale with object. And line caps. And so hope we have understood this too. But the topic now, how to curve a line? Because ultimately we'll be needing to make a line to curve. So make a straight line with the help of your F5. Rise the thickness a little. Switch to the F10 button. Select the nodes and turn into curve. Once it turns into curve, you can find the tangent, you can drag to the top and get it over. So hope we have understood now how to make a node to get tangent and how does a tangent can make the path to get it curve. Now is the next point. Once the curve is done, then if you need to make it straight, again, we need to switch to the convert to line. So hope we have understood now. Instantly, you can make it curve and you can drag it off. And then after here, if it is required, we can straight it up. So hope we have understood now these two buttons. What are the things we have learned inside the node basis with the shape tool? Addition of the node, subtraction of the node, join of the node, break the curve inside the nodes, make it convert to curve and convert to line. Bend on test state. So hope 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 option clear, 7 option clear, 8, 9 option clear. Is it done? Because CorelDRAW revolve around this 10-15 buttons. If 15 button okay, CorelDRAW okay. And it is related to what? To the path and spline. So select this, add up, midpoint came up. Then yes, you can smooth up. Once you're smooth, then you can find some difference here. It has been smoothed by auto, but there is an option here called smooth nodes. So hope this may help you out. Select. And if two side tangent, then it will come up. Smooth. Caps node. Symmetric. In symmetric, what happens? If you are dragging one side, the other side also drag. Now, if you are in caps mode, then each part could be controlled. Now, in the case of your middle one, the tangent will make a different power. So here you can see, this is what the problem. So hope we have understood again three options here. What are those? Smooth, symmetric, and caps mode. Is it okay, this all? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 options clear. 11 and 12. these two options also clear. So now it is the time to go for higher option learning. What is going on? Node modification. Select the nodes and get the rotation, scaling, rotation. You can set the center point. Right now, how to change the pivot point and how to rotate, that also we have understood. Now the next point, yes, select the nodes and get it rotate. We have seen it is a beautiful option, align the nodes. So check how to align the nodes, horizontal and vertical. So let us take some freehand lines and get them command so we can understand it easily. Let us combine all these things. There is a small button over here, combine. Now select the nodes. Get this button on. Go for horizontal. So all the points come into a single place. Go for horizontal. So hope we have understood now what is this button is doing. Align the nodes. Now reflect nodes horizontally and reflect nodes vertically. Again, it is a beautiful process. Just, I'm not teaching any new things. Very simple options we are talking about. This should come into your brain. Now, what is the option called? Reflect node horizontally and reflect node vertically. If you are selecting these two nodes and we are planning to go for reflection vertically and we are scaling this, one minute here. Hope we can all see now what is the difference. Horizontally, like vertically, you are making the lines to come closer or go away. Generally, it doesn't happen. If it is off, then if you are moving top, then all the keys selected will get moved. If you are down, then all the keys get down. But with this button on or this button on, we can make it to go in opposite direction. Is it clear? So hope this button two are clear. I'm just going icon wise so that it will not be a problem for you. Now the next. Here the next is elastic mode. What is elastic mode? Generally what happens if some nodes are selected, then it will be move by cursor like this. But instead of moving the complete nodes, we can take like high energy, low energy, like. So switch on this. Now it will work only for certain part. Elastic like behavior. Which never happens if this button is off. All the things will move similar. Now it is, they're compressing or exaggerating. So now what are the things we have learned? Elastic mode, symmetric reflection node, elastic node, reflection node, alignment node, scaling and rotation. Now the next is select all the nodes. So how to select? Just one button. Either we select one and control A or else click over there. Now the next is reduce node. If the design is drawn with unnecessary nodes, then the software may ask to reduce the nodes. F10. Select all, radius node. So the software is not telling it has been taken minimum only, so nothing to get out. If more zigzag are there, then radius node will work out. So hope all these options, and these are all the options are known to you. Hope it is now okay. We'll move to more two options in the shape tool. Radius node is clear. Make some zigzag line, and at that point we can have to see it up. If it is more zigzag, then select all and ask for radius node. Then software will try to get it reduce as many less as it is, and with minimum dots it'll make the surface. Fine, all these options are clear. This is the major part we have taken. Now let us go for next higher tool, 2-point line. So it is also a straight line. How we are making the freehand to get straight line? Same way we can able to make 2-point line. In this 2-point line, what happened? Just we need to track, but the next difference will start at these 2 points, at two options. Inside the 2-point line, we do find 3 more options. 1 2-point only, 1 2, but the second is perpendicular 2-point line. It will work nicely whenever line is there. If the next line has to be exactly perpendicular, then we can move to this. So often the browsers and all things will be perpendicular placed. And it is happening through this 2-point perpendicular line. And the next is tangent line. Tangent line always works on the curvical surface. So if it is a curvical surface, from the surface, we need 90 degree. Then we can switch to this, or like parallel to this. So the same flow will be required. For perpendicular, it is there. With the same flow, if we require, then you can see. So the same flow, we got to know how to make a slanting line. So now got to know 2-point line, perpendicular line, tangent 2-point line, note down. So what are the things we have learned? 2-point line tool. Then after, what is the next? Tangent line. So regarding the nodes, we need to specify what are the things we have learned about the nodes. Node detail. What are those? Add, subtract. Then after what? Linear. Convert to curve. Okay, select all node. Reduce node. Align node. After alignment, what is there? Symmetric, it's an important option. Symmetric horizontal and symmetric vertical scale. Next. What more we got to know? Elastic mode. Then change direction. Just I'm noting, because does these options are known to you or not? Check. If not, ask. Change direction. Close the curve. Hope node related, this many things we have understood. 1, 2, so you can see now this many, around 11 to 12 options you are aware of. So it's okay. And regarding the line tool, We have seen three type of rectangle are there. So these many options we have learned today. So how to use them, that depends, but yes, the all the options are known to you. That is quite simple. Kev's note can be explained. Yes. So do we get explained? Yes. Thanks for reminding. What is that? Kev's note. Kev's node is the options which make the line to get independently controlled. Example, so let us take a new piece. This is a line. And this point is to be get handled. That to be, if you are trying like this, then what happens? The other side is disturbed. Without disturbing, if you need to make the line to bend, that is done by the Kev's node. Kev's node is such an option which allow to make independent controller. Independent controller. Is it okay? And the other two are smooth and symmetric. Smooth may be small one side, maybe big one side. But the spline will be smooth. But if you go for like symmetric node, then both the sides are equal. If you are making small, the other one will be smaller. So hope we have understood now. Two more options, smooth node and symmetric node. So what is the difference between smooth and symmetric node? It may be a question. So make sure you are ready with the answer. Smooth node and symmetric node. So in symmetric, what happens? Both the side of the node will be same. If you are rising one, the other one rises. But it is not in the case of your. Okay. Hope all the options are done and I've made it clearly noted. Here you can make straight line, book cover page designing, make a new file, control N with A4 size paper. Get it okay. Now make a straight line somewhere here. Right. Now get the 2 point and switch to the perpendicular. Is it clear now? Because we are using an option called perpendicular to the line. So it always never allow you to make the bend perpendicular to the line. Wherever you click from that particular line, perpendicular. So making such a perfect line, sometimes difficult, but now it is easy. So hope we have understood now how to make a simple 2 point line to get it placed as a border or a split the screen. Split screen is a technique. So hope 2 point line is okay for the further process. Right now? Now we do have freehand line and 2 point line. Let us go for Bezier. Bezier, very simple. Click, click, drag. Right, let us check by taking a new place. Select the line. So let us make some design now. A lot of theory you have learned. Am I right? These many things, a test stretch you got to know. Rotate. Plus reference. Change the reference point. Select all, combine. Select the nodes by the option, what join the nodes, and then close the nodes. And you know how to close it up. So hope we have understood now how to make a close shape from an open scribble. Now it is to be get duplicate. Yes, duplicate by the option copy paste. Whatever. Copy and paste and change the reference point. Flip it out. And get it again duplicate by the copy paste. Turn down this. So select all the thing objects, and a lot of operations can be done with multiple objects. We have just started with combine, but it is not only combine, we can have to weld it up. So hope we have understood now how to make closed safe from the open safe by the help of your joining nodes and closing the nodes and getting symmetric and duplicate. Get plus sign, switch to the color, change is 45. That is done. Select all the objects, like two objects are now here. We can ask them to get it separate from each other in this way. Not in this way. So what you have seen now, how to generate a shape from this shape. Now check. Select all. Then duplicate it up by plus point or by copy paste. And select them. Get it into 45 divided by 2. Select, duplicate. 45 divided by 2. Why it is not happening? Just check how what value could be placed here. 45 degree. Guess exactly it is in the middle. Now fill the color. Now we'll be learning how to fill a color inside it. Just one click, it will fill up. Right click, it is only for strokes. So hope we have understood how to make a radial art from the click button. So out of that, we can get one particular separate by which option? It is already there in a combined format. We can go for break apart. Right now? So the task of the day. Hope the screen is visible. Right. And here we have seen how to make a radial art. There is a option. Select all. Get it copy paste. Now 45 divided by 2. So it is the middle overlapping area object. So get a duplicate of it so that original will not go. Select everyone and go for intersecting, like options are there. Intersect. Okay, or else. Now if already selected and combined is there, then you can find the intermediate to get delete. So combine is the option which makes the common area to get delete. That is also option, so you can try it out. So now what we have understood, we can make combine to multiple products and the common area will become transparent. That is the final output. Is it okay? Fine. Now within this, what is the doubt you can ask me? What are the things we have learned and what can be done? Optical illusion is clearly possible. radial art. So it is there on your screen. Now, any questions you can ask? So before furthering, putting further, then I just asked the question. So this many options to be checked up. So next question, question number one, task number one, task number two. Check all the property, modify property. Of a line. How many you find? 15 properties has been listed out. Out of that, all the things I'm not like out of that, everything you need to know. Then only the design will come. And by using the combine, we have made a radial art. So combine is a very beautiful option if multi object are there. So let us take this. Yes, tell me.
So how to use different color in this?
In different colors. So again, we need to draw it separately. Now it is a single object. We can fill in this way. Then we need to break the object. That will be coming later on. So for the timing, it is not a multi-object. It is a single object. That's why it is reacting in this way. We can break it apart and get them separate. So ungroup. So all the process could be done and to get it separate. Because this is not a single object. So hope we have got some idea like why it is not filled separately, because it is a single object altogether. We can see behind the screen by combining it as form, but it is multiple product. And again, this part separate, that all things will be done by the next command called shape breaking. So that will be coming later, but for the timing, yes.
Yes.
Single thing can be done. Fine, then hope we have understood now the two options very clearly. And we got to know a special thing today. What is that? Combine objects, make the common area transparent. Combine object, make the common area transparent. If multiple products are there, so wherever the common area, that become transparent. So two point line also a very wonderful option. If you are working on circles, then you can find it beautiful. And it does have three options. So making a perpendicular line from a line or from a curve, it becomes easier. Engineering drawings or like any layout you are making, then yes, this 100% perpendicular lines will help us to make a horizontal and vertical line without making zero mistakes, without making any mistake. The same thing if you're drawing with anything, then mistake will come. Fine. So hope these two options are very clear. Along with that, we have understood the option called F10 and its properties. So how many type of modifying options are there in CorelDRAW for a simple line to modify? These many nodes are there. Around how many we have noted over here? 15 options are there. All 15 options has to be under your control. Okay, so one more we can introduce and we will stop. Bezier. The name itself is answer. Bezier means it get a breeze out and make a smooth presentation. Click and drag. So no need to make a line, convert to curves, make the tangent, drag it up. All these things are done. By which? Bezier. Right now? And pen, Bezier are mostly same, but B-spline is a little difference. So we'll be talking about B-spline. What is B-spline? It is also a format to draw a line, but what happens, it takes 3 point average to make a bend. 1 point, 2 point, and 3 point. So it always makes the curve very smooth. fourth, click. So all the surface turn into except. But for the timing, we have understood now what is called the options of B spline. It is a option which is there in 3ds Max, Maya, everywhere. B spline is a spline which is much more smoother than all object, all tools above. Why it is so smooth? Question over. Answer: it take the average of three nodes and get the job done. That's why it is always smooth. How to modify a object which is B spline? Come to this shape tool and you can find the nodes called clamp. What is a clamping control point? One button go, it will drag it to the node point and it is relax. Good. That's it for the day. So making a water drop becomes much more easier by the B spline. We'll be learning about it in more details, but for the timing, we have understood now three tools maximum. B spline we have started. But options, a lot of options you got to know while node details. And task has been given, and the tools is this. And the other tools we have learned now. What is that tool? This B spline. So any questions you can ask. Bezier, we have to hold the mouse button. Yes, later on we'll see like in detail about holding mouse and what other things could be changed. But temporarily, just hold the handle of the Bezier, that will work out. It's okay now, ma'am? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Will I stop then? I'm stopping.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
We'll meet in the next session with higher offices. Bye for the day.
Thank you.